Story recapped here. Today I'm gonna explain an action, adventure, and comedy film called Sharknado. Spoilers ahead, watch out and take care. 20 miles off the coast of Mexico, a crew of seafarers is illegally capturing sharks and cutting off their fins before tossing the remains back into the sea. Below deck, Mr. Palmer is trying to make a deal with the captain, Santiago, to purchase their goods. However, the two can't seem to agree on a price, but Santiago tells him that there's a pod of 20,000 sharks coming in their direction, so the price is worth the large catch. Still, Palmer tries to ask for a lower price and only concedes when Santiago pulls out a gun, implicating a threat. So Palmer hands Santiago a deposit of 100 grand. Suddenly, a brewing storm shakes the ship, making Santiago check what's going on above. But when he goes back down, Palmer is gone with a gun and deposit. Meanwhile, sharks get above board because of the storm, eating away at the crew members. Palmer takes advantage of this commotion to attack Santiago and take his belongings. However, his plan fails when Santiago shoots him in the leg. Soon, Palmer gets eaten by a shark while Santiago falls upon the effects of a storm that's carrying sharks. At the Santa Monica Pier, the friends Baz and Finn enjoy a wonderful time in the ocean, surfing and jet skiing. On the other hand, George, a regular bargoer, and Nova, the waitress, see news coverage about the oncoming storm heading towards Santa Monica. Immediately, Nova is concerned about her boss, Finn's safety. A little later, George notices the scar on Nova's leg and asks what happened to it. However, she's secretive about the cause. Meanwhile, Finn joins another surfer along the waves while Baz watches closely behind his jet ski. Suddenly, Finn notices a shark approaching them and warns the other surfer. However, it is much too late because she can't swim away on time and gets eaten by the pod of sharks swimming toward her. All the while, Finn watches this happen before shouting a warning to everyone on the beach, but nobody hears him. It isn't until a man gets eaten that a lifeguard tells everyone to evacuate. While chaos ensues on the shore, Baz tries to drive away, but a shark bites him on the leg. Thankfully, Finn rams his surfboard onto the shark so they can escape inland. Nova runs to the two immediately while a first aider takes care of Baz. Moments later, the group is back at the bar to talk about the incident, thinking that everything is back to normal. George doesn't believe what happened, so Baz shows him his injury. Furthermore, they think that the storm is no big deal until George points out that there seems to be an oncoming tornado. When Nova tries to flirt with Finn, he shakes her off. A little later, another news coverage details the severity of the situation, so Finn calls April, his ex-wife, to check on his family. But she thinks he's overreacting and is just trying to get closer to them, so April hangs up on him. As Finn checks the oncoming storm, he closes the bar to secure the place. He tells everyone to leave for safety, but Nova, George, and Baz stay with him. Suddenly, a shark smashes through the window, so Nova immediately kills it with a pool stick. They hurriedly find weapons before evacuating. Outside, Nova gets attacked by a shark and cannot shoot it with her shotgun. Fortunately, George comes to the rescue and hits it away with his bar stool. With the storm worsening, more sharks land on shore, but Finn is able to shoot a shark that is coming for Baz. Because of the strong winds, the pier's Ferris wheel goes loose and rolls down the area. Seeing the destruction of his bar, Finn becomes worried for his family and decides to visit them. Still, his friends come with him. On the way there, the storm slowly worsens and starts flooding everywhere, bringing sharks to the streets. So they take another route, hoping the water hasn't risen too much inland. However, it seems like everyone has gotten the same idea because of the extreme traffic, but the waves crash down the streets before they could get further. With sharks coming down from the sky, the group sees people getting attacked left and right by the predators. So Finn exits the car to help other people that are freaking out. Reluctantly, his other friends join his cause despite the danger. While the group helps everyone escape, George assists one woman that got her dog stuck inside her car. Afterward, they meet back up by the car, but George gets overtaken by the shark-filled waves. With no time to waste, the group goes back inside the car before driving away, with Finn making sure that he times the waves properly to help them cross. Soon enough, they get to April's place, so Finn starts banging on the door. When his ex-wife greets him at the door, she immediately starts sending them away. However, a surge of water bursts through the sewage alongside a shark. Nova kills it with her shotgun immediately, so April lets them in. Finn tries to talk to his daughter Claudia to bring them to safety, but they still underestimate the storm. Suddenly, April's boyfriend Colin tells Finn to leave because he has no right to be there. Still, the group was nice enough to warn them about the storm of sharks, with Nova pointing out that there's a shark in their swimming pool. With a scoff, Colin checks it for himself because he doesn't believe it. Just as Colin looks through the window, the shark bursts through the glass and attacks him. On the other hand, the group tries to find elevated safety. When Colin starts getting eaten, Finn doesn't hesitate to help Colin, but it's already too late for him. The group manages to fend off the shark by dropping a bookcase on it. Still, the shark gets away until Nova riddles it with bullets. Despite getting rid of one shark, another one immediately follows, but they're already out of ammo. As they recuperate, Finn tells them where to go before the eye of the storm hits, but Claudia cuts him off, saying they need to get Matt, Finn's son, first, because he's currently in flight school. Afterward, Finn distracts the shark so the rest can run to the car before immediately following. They drive away just as the house bursts from the overflowing flood. While on the road, the news has just started to cover the influx of sharks coming from all over. All the while, Nova refills her ammunition because Finn has extras in his truck. While on the way, Finn stops after seeing a school bus stuck in the middle of the flood. Despite April's complaints to keep going, Finn can't ignore the possible children in danger, so he parks at the side of the road to rappel down the bridge. True enough, there are children stuck inside the bus with the driver trying to comfort them. As Finn rappels down, the group manages to pull the children up to safety one by one. Once it's time for the driver to go up, he's worried that the rope might not be strong enough for him. Suddenly, a shark jumps up the bus roof before they can pull him up. Thankfully, they manage to fend it off before it bites anyone. Soon enough, they pull the driver to safety before bringing Finn back up while sharks jump up to reach him. Meanwhile, one of the sharks gets wrapped around the wrap, lagging behind Finn, so Finn cuts off the end of the rope, successfully getting back to the bridge before the rope could snap. With the sky looking so clear, the group thinks that it's finally over. But just at that moment, the effect of the tornado starts dawning upon them as the wind sends debris flying all over. Although the bus driver avoids most of them, he meets his demise after a large chunk lands on him. Soon, they run into car trouble as they see water spouts around the city because of the tornado. Furthermore, April notices that sharks are getting sucked up into the air, making a full-on sharknado. While back on the road to pick up Matt, a shark bites through the car's roof, so Finn tries pushing it away with a bat. However, the shark just bites away the flimsy weapon, injuring Finn, so Nova makes Finn hold on to the wheel so she can shoot the shark. A little later, the car breaks, and Finn starts to smell gas. He orders the group to run away just as the car explodes behind them. They get to a convenience store, but the phones are still dead, so they just start getting themselves some rations. While doing so, Claudia starts talking to Nova, asking about her weird name, so Nova explains that she simply renamed herself. Furthermore, Claudia notices that Nova seems to like Finn, so Claudia tells her that Finn will just hurt her. Meanwhile, the news is giving updates about the storm, but the store clerk thinks it's all just an exaggeration. Furthermore, he thinks that the government is behind everything, most likely a conspiracy theorist. With their car gone, Boz spots a movie car rental, so they manage to procure another vehicle. While driving, Boz drives past police officers that barricade the road, so they start getting pulled over. However, their priority is to pick up Matt before the storm comes back, so they just ignore the officer and speed away. Soon, they lose the cops and arrive at Matt's flight school. There, they get a closer look at the horrifying Sharknado. At first, they don't see anyone around the place, but then a sudden banging spooks Nova, so she pulls up her shotgun while looking around. Suddenly, she sees a group of people taking cover from the storm, so she immediately looks for Matt. As they regroup, they explain the situation to Matt, but again, the shark bit always catches them off guard. Because of their flimsy cover, Matt tells them to find better things to protect themselves. However, one of the people doesn't believe the shark thing, so she checks it out. Suddenly, the tornado bursts through the window and sucks the woman out, screaming that it's a Sharknado. Immediately, the group hides behind the flimsy cover again and waits for the tornado to pass. However, they know that there are three more incoming tornadoes, so they check their options for safety. Although Matt can fly them out, they think it'd be impossible for air travel given the current weather, so Finn tells them that they should stand their ground and fight the sharks. With that, they go to a nearby surplus to get weapons, but because the store is locked, Nova shoots the doorknob open. Suddenly, Matt comes upon an idea, so he pulls Nova along. He suggests making bombs and riding the helicopter so they can drop the bombs in the middle of the tornado to take care of the shark situation. Furthermore, Boz backs up the idea with some science, mentioning that the bomb might equalize the clashing air and stop the tornado. However, he mentions that if they miss, it'll be risky. After hearing Matt's idea, his parents, April and Finn, immediately protest, but Matt is adamant about wanting to save others if he can. Meanwhile, Claudia is having a miserable time by herself because she's jealous that Finn and April seem to be more attentive towards Matt but not her. So Finn tells her that he came looking for her first when he heard the news about the storm. While working together, Matt notices that Nova's self-conscious about her leg scar, so Matt shows her his own gnarly scar to make her feel comfortable. Still, Nova doesn't like talking about it, but somehow, Matt got her to open up. So Nova tells him the story of being swarmed by sharks and losing her grandparents due to the incident. Furthermore, just when she was getting saved, a shark bit her and ended up killing the rescue team as well, leaving her as the only survivor. Afterward, the group starts loading the bombs into the helicopter just as the tornado dawns nearer. Meanwhile, Boz gets ready for a plan B, preparing to sacrifice himself by driving a car straight inside the storm to set off a bigger bomb, despite knowing it'll kill him too. As Nova and Matt take off, they try to avoid the sharks flying toward them, so Finn provides backup by shooting them away. When they finally get close to the storm, Nova immediately prepares to drop the bombs. Then, Matt instructs her on operating the bomb, successfully dispersing one of the tornadoes. As the sharks rain on the ground, the group does their best to protect themselves with whatever weapon they have, such as Finn's chainsaw. However, some of them still meet their unfortunate demise when a shark lands on them. Furthermore, Boz gets bitten again before the wind takes him with a shark. Despite wanting to save his friend, Finn knows that they must run away to safety. For the second tornado, Matt and Nova were able to disperse it once again, but the onslaught of raining sharks still isn't giving them much chance for survival, as one of the people with them meets their demise. In the nearby retirement home, Finn helps the elderly get to safety, before dousing gasoline into the pool and setting it on fire. As the pool explodes behind Finn, he runs inside the shelter for cover. Meanwhile, Matt and Nova face the third tornado, but it's noticeably bigger than the previous ones. Despite their concerns, Nova still drops the bomb. However, the bomb doesn't land right, and they fail to disperse it. With zero bombs left, Matt decides to fly back to base. However, a shark bites their vehicle. Although Nova manages to get the shark off, she slips off the helicopter too. With Matt struggling to stabilize his vehicle, he crash lands onto the field while Finn runs to save him. Thankfully, he was still able to land safely with minimal injuries. Afterward, Finn tells Matt to get to safety, telling his son that he'll finish the rest. With no other choice, Finn takes Boz's vehicle to execute Plan B. But instead of driving into the storm with a car, Finn jumps off the vehicle just as he detonates the bomb. With that, he successfully disperses the final tornado. Afterward, his family runs to him, but a shark comes flying toward Claudia. So Finn pushes her out of the way, hoping to slash the shark with his chainsaw. However, he dives straight into its mouth, but he manages to survive and chainsaw his way out of its innards. After escaping, Finn pulls an unconscious Nova out of the shark too. Then Matt immediately performs CPR to save her. Right away, Nova starts coughing out the water in her system. Just then, the sky starts clearing up, providing relief to the people nearby. Then, Matt asks for Nova's real name, Jenny Lynn. Meanwhile, Finn and April make up.
Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Turn on notifications. And leave a like, it really helps the channel out. Thank you for watching.